Dean on the scene here for Arlington in the Morning, WERA 96.7 FM, here at the second annual DC Black Film Festival. And this next man, I've been hearing some good things about you and your movie. Prakeem, how you doing?
Nice to meet you. Thank you. Thank you.
Nice to hear from you, and nice to see you, and nice to talk to you. You're doing a movie called Stuck, which I heard so much about. For those who are not know and are not here to watch it, shame on you. Tell us about Stuck.
Awesome. So Stuck is about two strangers. They hook up for a one-night stand, mm-hmm. and they get stuck in the act of a one-night stand. And so they have to get to know each other, and that's the only way that they can separate.
Amazing. So is this your very first film festival?
No, it's not my first festival. I had a feature that I did called The Muddy Lions back in 2013, but mm-hmm. this is probably the first festival I've done since 2015-16, so it's first short I've done in a while.
Amazing. So how did you hear about the DC Black Film Festival?
I think I just found it on Film Freeway and was like, all right, this is a film that supports black artists. It's in my hometown. I'm from Richmond, Virginia, but I went to Howard University. So I just
HBCU.
Submitted. HBCU, absolutely. So I just figured I would submit my film and see what happened. And once we got in, I knew that I wanted to come to the Chocolate City and support.
When did you realize that you wanted to become a filmmaker?
About 15 years old. I realized that professional basketball was not going to be the option.
And is that always the case, you know?
Yeah, and it's like, all right, LeBron James, same year as me. Clearly he's better, I'm not going to make it. So I found a career where I was able to combine my passions of writing, photography, and music, and found filmmaking. It was like, all right, this is what I'm going to work towards. Went to undergrad for film, master's for film, and pretty much that's all I've been doing since I was about 15 years old.
Amazing. So who were some of your major influences in order to become a filmmaker?
I would say Spike Lee is probably one of my biggest influencers. Just seeing someone who looks like me being able to make movies and seeing the consistency, the fact that he's able to make like one movie a year has always been inspiring. But I'm a fan of Tarantino. I like a lot of great directors. Anybody who can tell a great story and evoke emotion, I'm a fan of their work.
Wonderful. And I heard from one of the fellow filmmakers that your father is an author. Is that correct?
Yes, my father's out here supporting the film, and he is an author. He wrote a book called Wonders that deals with race relations in America. And so it's something he created back in 2008. And it's definitely, you know, a solid book. It's definitely a very good read.
Awesome. Aside from your film, have you seen any of the other films, and do you have a favorite among them?
Okay, so I have two favorites. I would say Rumination was mm-hmm. one of my favorites, and I thoroughly enjoyed Deeds Not Words, which was about this amazing civil rights activist pioneer named Robert Madison, who was like a Buffalo Soldier, ended up like ground-breaking architects and design like the Rock and Roll Museum. So just a lot of great history and so many great films, but those are two of my favorites at the festival.
Excellent. For somebody who has not come to the DC Black Film Festival, what would you say to have them come out next year, 2019, 2020, or even tonight if they're sitting in the couch doing absolutely nothing, but they need to be here?
If you love art, if you like black cinema, DC Black Film Festival is the place to be. They have some of the best up-and-coming filmmakers here, present at the festival for audience goers to actually talk to and connect with. And if you just like seeing great movies, this is the place to be. I mean, you're going to see films that you probably won't see in the theater, and they're great, they're made by us, and this is the best place for you to support the community.
Awesome. And where can we find you if people want to follow you on social media?
I'm pretty much Prahim on social media. It's P-R-A-H-E-M-E. And that's my website. That's where they can find out more information about my films or just kind of where to see us as we move on the film festival circuit.
Awesome. Last question. What's next for you?
What's next? I have about three features written, and I'm looking for financing. There's a possibility we may turn Stuck into a feature. So I'm just kind of wide open. I'm going to take the opportunities and see like what presents itself and just try to keep creating. But I did want to give this to you. This is a little souvenir from our film, Stuck. Don't want to leave home without that. So nope. You got a lot of merchandise. Just want to share the word with everybody. And we know that we left our imprint on DC, so we're very grateful to be here with the Black DC Film Festival.
I have to admit, this is the very first time in an interview I ever got some prize to
and
take home with me.
I got swag in the bag, too. I'm going to hook you up off camera.
Oh, thank you. Guys, you heard it here. You come to a film festival, you get some swag.
Right.
Thank you so much.
Nice talking with you.